Okay, this is getting a little ridiculous. Back before there was the internet, or at least as we know it today, with things like Amazon Prime and next day shipping, or in some cases, same day shipping, the only way you could buy stuff for your Jeep was to thumb through a catalog and phone in an order. Or if you had one in your neck of the woods, you could always go to a store like 4-Wheel Parts and have them place an order for you. You know, because they wouldn't actually have what you needed in stock. But for better or for worse, being a Jeeper back in the Stone Ages and short on cash did help me to come up with a few solutions of my own. So if you haven't figured it out by now, a door hanger. That's what I'm making. And specifically, one that gets mounted onto the wall so that I can get my Jeep doors off the ground and out of the way. As you can see, I'm using project lumber. And essentially that means I'm using 2x4s that have already been pre-cut to 2-foot lengths. Now doing it this way did cost a bit more than buying a standard piece of 2x4. But the benefit of doing it this way is that I could get it home a lot easier in a two-door, and it eliminates the need for one of these. Now, before I get started, I'd like to point out that I've got a link in the description below, and it goes to our website, wayalife.com. And in it, you'll find a detailed write-up that includes all the tools and hardware that you need for this project. All right, with that said, I'm gonna take one of the 2x4s and I'm gonna make 3 marks along the length of it and centered within the width of it. The first one, I'm gonna locate 3 inches in. And then the second one, I'm gonna locate 12 inches in. And then the last one, I'll mark 3 inches in from the opposite end. Of course, being that the width of a 2x4 actually only measures 3.5 inches, the center point that we're going to locate is 1¾ of an inch. All right, now we can go ahead and take out a 7/32 inch drill bit. I'm going to load it up into a drill. Grab a pair of safety goggles, and then using these two pieces of wood as kind of a stand, I'm going to go ahead and drill straight through these marks that I made. All right, now we're going to take a measurement 4 inches down here, and 4 inches down here, and we'll mark it 3/4 of an inch up to mark its center point here as well. And then we'll do the same on this side, 4 inches in, 4 inches in and 3/4 of an inch in and 3/4 of an inch in. All right, so using the first piece that I drilled as a stand, I'm gonna go ahead and drill out the holes I just marked. I'm gonna go all the way through just as before. And then we're gonna repeat on this piece here. Dump all these guys out. And what I'm gonna need are these lag bolts. Separate the really long ones from the shorter ones. And we're gonna take these washers, get them set now. Okay. All right, now we can take this first piece that I worked on with the three holes in it, and we can take one of these pieces and set it up on top so that it's flush with the back. And then we're gonna use this piece as a guide to drill a pilot hole into the lower piece. All right, now we're gonna take the other 2x4, flip this guy over, and we're gonna repeat the process. You wanna make sure that you use the 2x4 specific to the side, because if the holes are slightly off, things won't line up properly. So make sure this is flush on the back. And then as before, I'm just gonna use it as a guide. Now we're going to take our lag bolts and we're going to secure it in place. And for this, you're going to need a 1/2 inch socket. Okay, now we can flip it over. Place our piece of wood on top. All right, now we're gonna go ahead and take our tape measure again, and I'm gonna mark 12 inches down here, and then come from that point, we'll go 6 inches and 1/8. It's pretty important to get these accurate. And then in this direction, we'll go 6 inches and 1/8. These two points right here, this is the actual distance between the top and the bottom hinges, at least from the base of them. It's exactly 12 1/4 inches apart. Repeat over here, 12 inches, 6 1/8, and 6 1/8. And then as before, we're gonna go ahead and mark 3/4 of an inch here as well. Now we're gonna go ahead and change out our drill bit, because unlike lag bolts that we're using, the screw eyes are only 1/4 inch in diameter. So I'm gonna use a 3/16 of an inch drill bit, so that's a little bit smaller and has more bite. So now we're gonna go ahead and drill down through these points. Two, three, and four. Let's go ahead and take off all these tags. Won't need these. And then we're gonna go ahead and install them into these holes. And then we're gonna use something like a screwdriver to help drive them in. You basically wanna bury them pretty much to where the label was. That'll be about 2 inches down. All right, that pretty much finishes the mount itself. Now all we gotta do is get it on the wall. Being that the walls in our garage haven't been finished, it's pretty easy to locate where all our studs are. But if your walls are finished, you're gonna need something like this. This is a stud finder, and it'll help you to locate where your studs are. Once you've determined the approximate height of where you want to hang your doors on the wall, you can go ahead and drill the uppermost hole of your mount onto your wall. All right, so now we're going to go ahead and put our 7/32 inch drill bit back into our drill. All right, so now we're going to grab one of these lag bolts and a washer. And we're going to thread it into our mount. And we're just going to get it started so that we don't have to do this all on the wall. There it is. All right, we can place it on the hole we just drilled. And then we can secure it to the wall. I think we're going to need an extension for this. Before we get too tight, let's go ahead and take our level. Make sure that it is actually sitting vertically. Okay. And then we can drill our other pilot holes. Finally, we can install the last two lag bolts. Moment of truth. Now it's time to get the doors. Ta-da! My do-it-yourself door hanger. Super easy to install, can be done in about half an hour using basic tools, and can all be had for about $16 and change.